In this chapter, you will share the project. In other words, you will configure the project for simultaneous work in the ArchiCAD teamwork environment. This way, multiple users can work on the same project simultaneously in complete harmony. In the second part of this chapter, you will also discover how a shared project can be further managed via the BIM Server Manager. Users and roles can be fine-tuned on a project level, allowing BIM managers great flexibility in dividing up work and responsibilities within the design team. Let's open the solo ArchiCAD project and share it for the ArchiCAD teamwork environment. Open the teamworktraining.pla file in ArchiCAD. Select the Read Elements Directly from Archive option in the Open Archive Project dialog, and click Open to proceed. The solo project archive will open in ArchiCAD, and the floor plan view of the project will be displayed on the screen. Select the Share menu item from the Teamwork menu. The Share This Project dialog comes up where you are automatically logged in as lead architect. If you are sharing the project from a different machine than the one on which you created the user accounts, you must identify yourself in the login dialog. In such cases, first select the server, then identify yourself as lead architect by entering the previously provided username and password for lead architect. From the category pop-up menu, you can choose or create a project category for your to-be-shared teamwork project. Categories are useful for offices where they have several shared teamwork projects running simultaneously on the same server. You can more easily differentiate between projects by using categories. We will not select or create a category for this project now. Leave the Enable Access of All Users of Server with Their Default Roles radio button selected. This means that all users defined in the BIM Server Manager will be enabled to join this project with their default roles. Later in this chapter, you will see how user roles can be further customized on a project level. Leave the Replace Linked Libraries with Server Libraries Automatically radio button selected. This means that all libraries currently linked to the project are uploaded or copied to the server. These libraries will then become server libraries that can be loaded into other teamwork projects as well. We will see how to work with libraries in detail later in Chapter 6 of Part 2 of this training guide. The Backup Options button brings up the Project Backup Schedule dialog box, where you can customize how often ArchiCAD will create a backup copy of the teamwork project. This option will be discussed in detail later in Chapter 8 of Part 2 of this training guide. Let's leave this dialog unchanged and click Cancel. Select the Share Without Joining option available by clicking the arrow icon to the right of the Share button. This means the project will be shared, but you will not automatically join the shared teamwork project as a user. Quit ArchiCAD. Do not save changes before closing the teamwork training project. Now the project is being shared and uploaded to the BIM server. Let's find out how the shared project can be further managed via the BIM Server Manager. Open the BIM Server Manager either through the BIM Server Control Center if the BIM server is running locally, or by launching the BIM Server Manager from the Graphisoft BIM Server folder. This program is located in the Programs folder on Windows or in the Applications folder on Mac. You can see that the Teamwork Training project is listed in the Projects panel under Server Module 17. Click on the Settings button to open the Settings dialog of the project. Let's now see what can be further specified in the Project Settings dialog for a shared teamwork project. Beside the project name, the Lock, Unlock toggle control allows you to temporarily lock all the users out from accessing this teamwork project on the BIM server. If the project is locked, it means that users can keep working on the project, but will not be able to send or receive project data to or from the BIM server. Click on the Project Log button to open its dialog box. The Project Log dialog box lets you view, filter, and even export to a text file all project activities of the shared teamwork project. These activities include logs about joining, leaving, sharing, loading of the project, and also list comments, send and receive logs, release of project data, and backups. The project log is useful for providing a snapshot of project progress within a given time frame. For example, to check whether all users really did send in their changes at a specific time or date. Click Close. The Users and Roles panel lets you control the list of users who have access to this project. In addition, you can use this panel to edit the project-specific role of a selected user, or to create a customized role for this project only. By default, everyone can access the project. Everyone is a special group user, which includes every user defined on the BIM server. You can add individual users to this project from the BIM server's user list by clicking the Add button and choosing their names. Even if you keep everyone as a user, you can add some of the usernames individually to assign them a project-specific role that is not their default role. This can be useful if a user's role is different from a specific project than his or her usual role. For example, Architect 1 could be added with a different role, such as a draftsman role. The result being that Architect 1 could work on this project as a draftsman only. However, let's not change the users and their roles for this project. Let everyone join in with their default role. The currently joined users list on the Users and Roles panel of the project settings gives you feedback on activities by users currently joined to the project. This information is useful for monitoring the server-related activities associated with the current project. You can send a message to any user by selecting the username and clicking the messaging button. Server or project administrators can also force a user to leave the project by clicking the Force Leave button. For example, if a user has something reserved that needs to be changed and they are not online. For example, they've left for home or on vacation or are sick. The Backups panel allows you to display and manage the project backups, both automatically scheduled and manual backups. You will discover the backup functionality in more detail later in Chapter 8 of Part 2 of this training guide. Click Cancel to leave the Project Settings dialog unchanged. The Projects panel of the BIM Server Manager also allows server administrators to create new shared teamwork projects from an existing one, either by duplicating a project or importing a teamwork project from a file or from another BIM server. Click the Libraries menu item on the left side of the BIM Server Manager to see which libraries have been uploaded to the BIM server. This teamwork training project used the Teamwork Training Project Archive, which has been uploaded to the BIM server. You will discover later how to manage BIM server libraries in Chapter 6 of Part 2 of this training guide. Click the Custom Properties menu item on the left side of the BIM Server Manager to see which properties can be assigned to users and projects. In the User Properties panel, server administrators can define custom properties, such as Skype address or location. This can help identify users more easily in a large organization. Once a user property is added, each user can fill out the required fields for themselves. In the Project Categories panel, server administrators can create categories, such as schematic designs or construction documentation for projects, to help identify shared teamwork projects, because the projects can be filtered by these categories in the relevant dialog boxes. Click the Server Activities menu item on the left side of the BIM Server Manager to see the sophisticated tools provided for the server administrator to control BIM server performance. These tools help the administrators monitor the server's up-to-the-minute memory usage and activities, monitor the server's performance history over time as correlated with distinct events in the server's event log. Check the size and status of the server's projects and users. Get an overview of server-related actions, globally, by project, and/or by user. For a detailed description of the above functionalities, please refer to the ArchiCAD reference guide. Close the BIM Server Manager. You have now shared the project and seen how the BIM Server Manager can help in monitoring managing the teamwork environment. You are now ready to discover in detail how users can work simultaneously and seamlessly in a shared project. In this chapter, you have seen how project administrators can easily share an ArchiCAD solo project via any client ArchiCAD version. You have seen how shared teamwork projects can be further managed by server administrators using the BIM Server Manager, and also got an overview of the sophisticated tools provided for server administrators in the BIM Server Manager to monitor BIM server performance.